Nigerian First Lady Aisha Buhari sends new message to Nigerians. First Lady Aisha Buhari has told Nigerians that she is concerned about the spread of the COVID-19 disease in Nigeria. She begged Nigerians to take social distancing more seriously, as cases have now passed the 1,000 mark. This was contained in a statement on Saturday by her special assistant on media, Alihu Abdullahi. It noted that Aisha has swung into action by activating her Get Involved initiative to support the fight. The president's wife has sent items to Bauchi, Gombe State, and the Federal Capital Territory. She expressed appreciation to those who donated, saying the nation will benefit from their donations. Mrs. Buhari called on Nigerians to stay safe and practice social distancing in order to defeat the COVID-19 pandemic. She called on the benefiting states to put the items to good use, the statement disclosed. Aisha was represented by her senior special assistant on administration and women affairs, Dr. Hajo Sani, during the distribution ceremony in Abuja. The items distributed include cartons of assorted hand sanitizers, pharmaceutical drugs, personal protection equipment, including disposable gowns and overalls. Others were disposable and 95 naira surgical masks, gloves, protective goggles, regular and ICU beds with beddings and automatic dispensers. That is the news story so far, guys. What are your thoughts on this particular issue? I think this is the first time people are getting to hear from the First Lady of Nigeria ever since the mention of the start of this coronavirus, the COVID-19 disease, and all that has been happening. So guys, what are your thoughts on this particular issue? What do you guys think concerning Aisha's Buhari's message? Now that she has sent some items to the Gombe State, Bauchi State, and the Federal Capital Territory, she expressed gratitude and appreciation to those who donated, saying that the nation will benefit from their donations. Well, guys, what are your thoughts concerning what the First Lady has said, Aisha Buhari? One would expect that we would hear more from the wife of the president now that the former chief of staff, late Abatiari, is dead, because from reports, it's been deduced that she was, you know, handicapped by the former chief of staff. Well, she has come out to say that to tell Nigerians to observe the rules, you know, set out by the NCDC. She has come out to also tell Nigerians to take social distancing more seriously, as cases have now hit past the 1,000 mark. Well, be that as it may, Nigerians should also take the social distancing serious. It's what it is. But the major challenge is even the northerners, who seem not to take the social distancing serious. They are the ones who are actually not serious with the social distancing, as they have been seen almost every time, or almost now and then, as they, you know, hold themselves together, meet, or even when they are praying at the mosque, or when they attend prayers or stuff like that, as it's been seen all across social media. But be that as it may, the First Lady of Nigeria has sent this message to Nigerians, so hope all Nigerians will take the message in good faith and also abide by the social distancing rule and policy to curb the spread of the COVID-19 disease, as no one is aware or no one knows who probably is already infected and who can transmit it to another person. Be that as it may, guys, what do you expect from the First Lady of Nigeria? Are there other expectations that are being expected from her? Or do you think that she has done enough, or she's doing enough at the moment to help fight and curb the spread of the COVID-19 disease? What are your thoughts concerning this particular news story, guys? She's in the Aso Rock and wielding power. And would you expect that she would do more? And now that the issue of the palliative is actually ongoing, she would reach out to more Nigerians, or she will be prevail on her husband to actually help reach out to more Nigerians that have actually been reached out to? Because the palliative measures that are actually in place are not getting to a good number or majority of the persons that are actually in need of these palliatives. So guys, what are your thoughts concerning this? What do you think? It is important for us to understand, for us to actually get across to the First Lady of the country, you know, in the clear terms. Well, she might not be the right person or the main person who is to make things work, but definitely she has a say, and she actually can speak to her husband, you know, because what is happening at the grassroots level is not what to write home about, and is not encouraging at all. So she could also help reach out to the president and those in power, so that things can be fixed and things can be done properly to help and also to get things working the way they ought to be. So guys, be that as it may, what are your thoughts concerning this particular news story? Sitting down in the Aso Rock and enjoying the goodies while people are suffering is not enough. The issue of the lockdown is also there. So, what are she? Someone, let's take a few comments on what people are saying. Someone said she and her husband have succeeded in importing the virus into the country by refusing to close the airports when the index case was recorded. She should bury her head in shame for being the wife of the president who could not build a cottage hospital, even in Aso Rock, and resorted to traveling abroad to treat even malaria. Nigerians blame Tinubu, Amaechi Oshiomhole, Aregbesola, and all the moles who ganged up and dragged Nigeria decades backward by bringing a principality on board. So guys, do you agree with this young man on this particular news story? Another person says, hunger is killing Nigerians, not COVID-19. Please tell your husband. Just what I was saying earlier, that she should reach out to her husband and let her husband know that those at the grassroots are not getting the palliatives. Those who need the palliatives are not getting them. So that is what we're saying. Hope that the wife of the president can actually prevail on the president to know that what is going on in his administration is not actually going on well. Emmanuel Geoffrey says, well done, but Bauchi, Gombe, and Abuja are not the only states in Nigeria. You can do more than that. Do you guys agree with Emmanuel Geoffrey? Yes, we do. Why not? That these things should go round and not just a sex, and which is the northern part that these guys are always going back to give to. Wells says, she is now the acting chief of staff. Do you guys agree with that? Someone else says, since the death of Abba Kyari, our First Lady is now talking to us every day. Is God not a wonderful God? That is what someone else says. Do you agree with this? Okechukwu Ndekwe says, you're now the president or asking, where is your husband and his vice? Breeze Onoja says, Madam Aisha, tell your husband to step down. The killing of innocent people's life is too much in Nigeria. Keep your advice to yourself. Failure to step down, there's not going to be peace for the entire family. All right, Peter, that's it today, guys. What are your thoughts? I'd like for you to please drop by at the comment section. Let us know what your thoughts are on this particular news story. Please do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Also, please hit the bell icon so you can get notification whenever we post new stories. Thank you so much for your time, guys. I appreciate your support, and I'll see you on the other news. Thank you, and bye for now.